good, good. Okay.
Well, you're going to be proud. I did most of it.
All right, you guys. So I've got 17 and 49. Let's go with that. What, Mary?
Oh, those are the same ones.
Oh, wait, Jordan. That was coming out of you. Yes?
Yeah, those are the same ones I won. 17 and 49.
Beautiful. Yeah. We're in good shape then. All right, here we go. 17. Is that the 2 plus 2 root x one? Is that the right one? 2 plus 2 root x? And we're integrating that with respect to x. So the first thing is to make everything pretty. So I'm going to do that.
Does it not have the 30-minute cutoff for video?
No, it does. I'm just going to
see if you can see the whole thing. Now tell me where that x to the 0th power came from. So x to the 0th power is just 1, and 2 times 1 is just 2. So I haven't integrated here. I haven't done anything yet. All I've done is make it pretty. So now I'm at the point where I can add. Okay. So my n plus 1 on this guy is going to be 1, and my n plus 1 on this guy is going to be 3 halves. Is everyone okay with that? Yeah. So then when you integrate, that becomes 2x to the 1st over 1, which I'm just going to leave, plus 2x to the 3 halves over 3 halves, plus some constant of integration. Well, what do I do with this guy?
Can't you bring it up?
Can I invert and multiply? So that 2 is going to get up here and become a 4 thirds. So this is going to be, oh, come on, Jess. Get it together. It'll be 2x plus 4 thirds. X to the 3 halves plus k. And you're done. So where'd you guys go off the rails?
I was just doing my
fraction. Okay.
Oh, hold on.
Jordan, where'd you go off the rails?
The back of the book says 2x plus 4 thirds x times square root of x.
Uh-huh. So here's why. X to the 3 halves is like saying the square root of x cubed, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, isn't that just the square root of x times x times x? So when we do square roots, we pull out pairs, right? So this becomes x to the square root of x, or x times the square root of x.
Oh.
Does that make sense? So what they did was they brought it back to the radical, and then they simplified it. So, but I could totally accept 3 halves.
You'd rather us do the 3 halves.
Yeah, I'd write it as 3 halves.
Yep,
it's
that's
easier
fine.
For me.
I'm fine.
But whatever floats your boat, guys.
I'm good.
Okay? All right. I'm so excited. 5 days from now, yes, 5 days from now, I'll be walking streets of Barcelona. Excited. That was sort of a manic grimace that you did. I need to go so bad. Yeah, I don't think for a second your teachers aren't looking forward to this as much as you are. Because, yeah. It's not that we're not going to wait for you guys. It's that we need a break too. C bar prime of x equals
we have 1/4
minus 100 over x squared. Okay, that's phenomenal. It gave you a derivative. And it says the average cost of producing 20 units is $40. Listen carefully. The average cost of producing 20 units is $40. This is your nugget. That thing I told you guys about that can help you find the constant integration. This is your nugget. Nugget.
What is that? What?
What?
What is it? What is it?
Nugget?
Yeah.
It's just a little kernel of information that you can use.
Oh, okay.
You know, like a golden nugget? A chicken nugget is a little thing. Depending on the context. In this context, it's the thing that you use to solve for the constant of integration. It's just a little thing. All right. So, in order to get to C bar from the C bar derivative, what do, guys?
Oh.
We're going to integrate. We're going to integrate with respect to what? Yeah. 1/4 minus, and I'm going to go ahead and make this pretty. So we have all of that with respect to x. Is everyone cool with how I set this up? All right. Then what? And then, let's see, the negative 2 plus 1 becomes negative 1. So we're going to get negative 100 over negative 1, making what? Positive 100 x to the negative 1. Plus some constant associated with average cost. Are we done?
No.
No, what do we need to do now? We're going to plug 20 in for x and 40 in for C bar. Because remember, it's not just the right-hand side of this equation. It's also equal to something. It's equal to C bar. So we're going to take that C bar, and we're going to plug in 40 for it. We're going to take this x, and we're going to plug in 20 for that, and we're going to see what we get. So 40 equals 1/4 times 20. Plus 100 over 20. Wait, where did I get the 100 over 20, guys?
You brought the 20 down.
Yeah, I brought this x to the negative 1 down and made it x to the positive 1, and then I plugged 20 in for it. You guys with me? So now I have, where I had three unknowns in one equation, now I have one unknown in one equation. Can I solve for that unknown? Yeah. What's 20 divided by 4? What's 100 divided by 20?
5.
What's 5 plus 5?
Yeah.
10 plus what equals 40?
30.
Case of C bar equals 30. You can do a lot of this in your head without ever touching a calculator, guys. In fact, it's faster that way. So now what's my real average cost function? One fourth times what? Plus what? Yeah, plus 30. Done and dusted. Talk to me. Where'd you guys go off the rails? Yeah, Alex. I'm just gonna bring this back downtown and change the sign. Same thing from here. Or I could do this x over 4 plus 100 over x plus 30, which is probably what the back of the book has.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, average cost of 100 units, you put in C bar of 100, that's going to be what? 100 over 25 is, or 100 over 4 is 25, 100 over 100 is 1, 25 plus 1 is 26, plus 30 is 56. The average cost of 100 units is $56 per unit. How do you guys feel about that?
The word's going
to happen. Don't let that happen.
Thank you.
Ryan. Ryan, Jordan, and Alex, she's not here. Madison,
really?
Brittany. Dustin, Jackson, Dean.
Not being here when you started.
Oh.
We only did homework, that's it.
It was just homework.
Yep.
This is all review. Alrighty then. Let's do some mathy math math. Jump to the fourth power. So, oh hell, I hope you guys have got this down. And then that's d out, so what's dn? The derivative of the inside, so 8x minus 8. You guys okay with that? So I'm going to reorganize this just a little bit. So I'm going to say the derivative of y with respect to x was just this, so I'm just going to bring the 8x minus 8 out front. Like this. Is everyone cool with what I've done so far? Yep, I just brought it out front. Because I've got something times something times something, and can you move around the somethings when you're multiplying?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Okay, so now I'm going to integrate. I'm going to split up my differentials and I'm going to integrate. So now I've got y equals the integral of 5 times 8x minus 8 times 4x squared minus 8x to the fourth power with respect to x is in time.
Thank you.
Welcome. Well, that's a beast, isn't it? That doesn't look anything like our first integral. What we do have is a function to a power times another function, don't we? Here's our function to a power times another function. You guys with me so far? So this is where those rules come in, the steps that are underneath your integration process. I'm going to talk you through it, and oh my God, you guys, If you follow the rules, you literally can't screw it up if your algebra is correct. If you don't follow the rules or you skip one, I promise you, you're going to have trouble getting these correct. So let's talk through these. The first step is make it pretty. Get it all on one line. That means get rid of denominators, get rid of radicals. Have we done that? Step two, find U, create U prime. But what else did I put on step one? Yeah, which integral is it? So now you need to recognize that you have a function to a power times another function. So you're dealing with integral number two here. Okay, this is not x to a power, this is function to power. All right? Next step, find U, create U prime. Oh boy. So if you're looking at your template on your tattoo, where is U located? Well, tell me what it is over here. Tell me where U is located there.
This is the power.
Go ahead.
The 4th squared minus 8x to the 4th.
Yeah, it's that, but what is it here? Where is U located here in relation to everything else? Yeah, look.
It's associated with the power.
It's associated with the power. It's tied to the power. Does everybody see that? So now let's locate our U here. What's U?
4x squared.
Which you guys said already. 4x squared minus 8x. Now it says create U prime. That wording matters. If you look here for U prime, that may not be U prime. So never look to this for U prime. Always create U prime from your U. So remember when I said we were done with derivatives? Yeah, I kind of lied. But it's okay, they're easy derivatives, right? They really are easy derivatives. So what's U prime?
8x from minus 8.
Yeah, there you go, Junior. 8x squared minus 8. So the next step is what do we have and what do we want? In order to integrate properly, we need exactly this. No more, no less, no different. Okay? The only way we can integrate this properly is to get exactly this inside the integral. So what do we have where U prime should be sitting? This is what we have. We have everything but U prime or U to the n power, right? This is our U, this is our n. So by default, this is where what we have where U prime should be. Is everyone okay with this? What do we want? We want exactly U prime. We always want U prime. Always, 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 always. Because that is what gives us exactly what the template looks like. So if we want 8x minus 8, but we have 5 times 8x minus 8, what do we need to do?
Distribute.
Well, if we distribute, that gives us 40x minus 40. Is that what we want? Okay, so we're not going to do that.
Divide by 5.
If we divide by 5 on this side, can we do that though? Not quite. We're almost there. Look at the very bottom of the left-hand side of your tattoo. There are two things, the also. Under the also, there are two little reminders there. One says that integrals can be separated and integrated separately if they're separated by plus or minus. And the other one says that constants can go outside of the integral. Do you guys see that? Okay, so what can we do with that 5?
Multiply by 4.
I can just bring it out here?
Oh, yeah.
That's flipping awesome. Okay. So y equals 5 times the integral of 8x minus 8. 4x squared minus 8x to the what power?
4th.
With respect to x. Now, do I have exactly u prime u to the n? Yeah, I do. So what's my integral? Once I get exactly the template, now's the time to integrate. So we just plug and chug, guys. What's our u? 4
squared.
4x squared minus 8x. What's n plus 1 going to be?
5.
And we divide by 5. And what goes out here? constant coefficients go along for the ride. Okay? Plus some constant. Now, what cancels?
The fives.
The fives cancel. Leaving us with what? Leaving us exactly where we started.
That's
yeah, it's a few. Yeah.
Why did you divide by five there?
Why did I divide by five? The great question. Because it's part of the template.
Oh, okay.
So once I get to this point, I just plug and chuck. Once you've completed the template, guys, it's literally plug and chuck. Anything that's outside of the integral comes along for the ride because it's now a constant coefficient. Yes?
So like test or homework, you really want us to do all these steps. You do? And not just go straight to it? That's too much work.
Suck it up, Sparky.
Sorry.
It's not that much work. How many steps is this? You're gonna be given this step right here. This is where you start.
Oh.
This is not a lot of work, is it?
Wait a second, you're right about that.
That's right. Yes, Eli.
So if it's given to us, why are we doing this?
What do you mean if it's given to you?
Didn't you give us that y equals 4x squared minus 8x to the fifth?
Well, yeah, I mean, that's where we started. But then we took the derivative, and then we went backwards so that we can end up where we started. Look at the very top of your tattoo. Those circles, we just did the entire circle. We did the derivative, and then we integrated and ended up back where we started. And I did that to illustrate that if you follow the steps exactly, you will end up with an integral that makes sense. Eli? Taking, yeah, exactly. So if you're done here, but you started here, the way that you check your work is you take the derivative. And if you end up with what you have in here, then you're good to go. Okay? We just started at a different place. Let me demonstrate. What? You look so upset, man.
Upset.
Like, you got feisty in the last week. What's going on with you?
I don't know. Just, you know.
That's good, though. I
messed up my back at the gym. I'm being kind of mad.
I'm sorry.
It's better now, you know.
Have they got you on the good stuff?
yeah. Take, you know, Aleve, you know. I don't know.
I'm telling you, man, Aleve makes you cranky.
Probably, yeah.
A little bit cranky. It's okay, though. Let's do this one. Walk through your steps. Is it pretty? Because of that, you've got to resolve the exponents before you do multiplication. No, it's a good question. Proud question. Okay. So u is tied to the exponent. U is 3x squared plus 4. Create u prime. Don't look up here. Create u prime. What is it?
6x.
What do we have where 6x should be?
In the front, right where it should be.
So remember, our template should look like u prime u to the n. We have u, it's set in stone. We have n, it's set in stone. Do you guys notice that the only thing we manipulate here is u prime? That's it. U and n are set in stone. Carpal tunnel.
Wait a second. This is not a product rule, or is it?
No.
No, it's not a product.
No. We're integrating. No derivatives here. So we have 6x. We want 6x. Do we have what we want?
Yes.
So what's the integral?
that minus the dx plus k.
Wait, whoa, no, not quite. So look at your template. That's what you're doing. What's our u? What's our n plus 1? Now you're done, Logan. You tell me.
Where did that 6 come from?
Oh, it's
5 plus 1.
Oh, crazy.
6x is part of what?
Did you read a some
u prime. And when we integrate, what do we do with derivatives? What are we doing to derivatives when we integrate? We're undoing them, right?
Yeah.
So what do you think happens to u prime when you integrate?
You undo it, right?
Well, it goes away, right?
Oh, yeah, because we're doing the same.
Remember, going the other way, the derivative that is tied to this is y equals u to the n. Y prime equals n u to the n minus 1 times u prime. U prime shows up when you take the derivative. It disappears when you integrate. Does that make sense?
Yes.
So these are the paired processes that you're using here. This is where you're starting. This is where you want to end up, which is essentially just this. Okay. How do you guys feel about this? Oh yeah, we're gonna do a crap ton more.
No, I just turned on.
Cause I want to make your life miserable, Chantel. Because I want you to be prepared for the homework. That's why. Because they're not going away. Make it pretty.
Make it beautiful.
Find you. Create you prime. You have, you want. Make it look like what you want for forming the integral. Those are the steps. It's all there for you. If you follow the steps, you can't screw it up, guys.
Slide, you know? Excitement from the top to the end.
You have all the steps. All you have to do is follow the steps. That's the beautiful part. What is that? The half? Because it's u-prime. U-prime disappears when you integrate. No, it's a whole different animal. You're thinking of taking derivatives. We're undoing that. If you were going d out dn, which is what you think, you think the one half comes down. We're undoing that. That is the derivative. Now we're trying to get back to where the original function was. Yes?
Where'd you get 2/3 from? That's the only part I missed.
Okay, what's 1 half plus 1?
3/2.
Yeah, but then how did you get 2/3?
In the end, 2/3.
Well, I have a denominator that's a fraction, so I'm going to invert and multiply. So the 2 is going to come up and the 3 is going to stay down. And you're going to get 2/3 instead of divided by 3/2. Okay. As a reminder, guys, when you have... anything divided by a fraction... invert the bottom fraction and multiply. Okay, so it doesn't matter what's up here, you invert this. So 7/3 becomes 3/7 up top. 3/2 down below becomes 2/3 up top. Okay? Basic algebraic rule. Questions about this one?
Can we leave it like that?
Yeah.
Yep.
Part that I circled?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's perfectly fine.
Okay.
Yep. When it comes to plugging in numbers, sometimes it's easier to convert it. And I'll show you when that's appropriate, but really, for just the pure math problems, you can totally leave it like this. When you're getting into the application problems, it might be easier to convert it back to a radical, because you can, how many of you know what 100 to the half power is? Yeah, that's right. What's the square root of 100? Everyone knows the square root of 100, but nobody knows 100 to the half power. You guys know it's the same thing.
Oh, yeah.
Right? But we get turned around. We get turned around when we have, when we're actually plugging in numbers to a power that's a fraction. But when we put it back into root form, our brains can easily calculate what that is. Right? And
no,
Eli.
No, me too.
It was me.
I didn't hear you.
I'm taking it.
She did? Okay, so Chantel, Gary, and Eli get the extra credit.
What? Finally caught us.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, where is it?
It is Gary, right? I'm learning. And Jen.
Okay, no.
And Ben. And beautiful handwriting.
Lauren.
Lauren! I'll get it eventually. And Leslie. Now I have my front row. Alright.
Wow, and you're halfway through
Lauren,
the semester.
Ben, Leslie, Carissa, Chantel, Alex, Junior. That's one row. I got four more. Three more. I don't know, whatever. Gary, I can do this. Brian, Alejandro,
with an H.
Hang on. Yeah, Brian with an H. Yeah, Alejandro with a J. Not with an H. Hang on, don't tell me. You have a beautiful name, but it's unusual. What is it? Amara, that's right. Edward, that's a row. I'm working on it, guys.
Oh, you just give up on us.
Wednesday, you gotta do the third.
Wednesday, I've gotta do the third.
I see. Did you know she was doing it? Kind of took you on me.
Okay, so if that's 20, this becomes 200, doesn't it?
My apologies, people. Sorry.
Well, I gave you credit.
I know.
Alright. It's been a good day.
Yeah.
All right, let's do some more.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Because you have a whole process to go with, right? The process helps you out.
That's perfect.
Pretty bad.
No, it's fine. Doesn't matter. Do you know what you're looking at?
Sometimes I think it's bad.
Yeah, just make it an elongated S. It's fine.
Do you draw a perfect one at the top?
I've drawn many.
I want that one.
You want that one?
Four times x minus one. Five times two x squared.
I don't know what to do, man. Draw a vertical line and put a little hook and a little hook. No. Well, I took many classes, but not this. Yes.
Yes. Okay, so we have 4x minus 4. I was so right to multiply it by 4. Damn it, I was wrong. I'm really surprised I'm functioning right now.
Process and what you guys, once you guys get used to that. Divide by 4, because that's the only way I can do this without changing the nature of the function. Mm-hmm. Multiplying by 1 changes nothing. Multiplying by 4 changes everything. So if I include this, exactly. And you can check your work. If you were to do this without the 1/4 out front, you wouldn't get the same answer as where you started. If you took the derivative out here of just this part, you're not going to get the answer that you started with. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah.
Multiply by 4.
Questions, guys?
Yeah. So pretty much multiply by 4 times the 3.
Also, let me remind you guys of one thing. Have not integrated. I have integrated. What went away between here and here?
4x minus 4.
Oh, the right thing.
My command as well. Yeah, absolutely. Also, my u prime disappeared, right? My 4x minus 4 went away. My command bracket of integrate with respect to x went away because I've done it, right? So those of you that persist on drawing the little squiggly after you've integrated, don't do it, because that's telling me that you have not yet integrated. Does that make sense? Okay. So here's where the math starts to get a little bit strict. I've been pretty loosey-goosey with you guys up until now, but now I'm going to get a little strict. Now, on a test, if you happen to throw the integral command in there, I'm not going to punish you. Unless you integrate twice, then I'm going to nail you. Right? Okay. But I want you guys to start to get familiar with this process. have not integrated, integrated. So integrate with respect to x is have not, because I did it. It's like a checklist. Questions about this problem? What was the hardest part?
Algebra.
Algebra?
I forgot to bring the x minus 1.
Figuring out how to get u prime to match. Yeah. Good, Lauren. Yeah. How to get from have to want. That's probably the most difficult part here.
Seriously?
What?
Yep.
Yeah, that's the most difficult part. So we're going to do more of this.
La, 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 la.
So who has ruminated on your spirit muppet? You guys figured out what your spirit muppet is?
Kermit.
Damn it. Why did I do that? Do you want me to give you like softballs all day long and you go home and get hit with hardballs on the court?
Sure.
No! You have some hardballs on the court. That way you know what the hell you're looking at.
Okay, we have to make it pretty.
Yes, you can. What's the first step?
The first step is the
cushion.
No.
How do we make it pretty?
Use the quotient rule.
You bring it up and change the
sign
of the
power.
Exponent, power, yes. So let me write that first step up there.
And then continue.
And I'm going to put it where I want because I do what I want. Right, so I just sandwiched it right between the 5x cubed and the dx.
You didn't change the sign.
Yes,
oh,
she
I
did.
You didn't. What's your name again?
Brittany.
Brittany with an A, right?
Yeah.
What the crap, man?
Caught me a mistake. Good job. That makes me happy.
Rock and roll.
Just did this today.
Okay, so now we will.
Nice catch, Brittany. Now what? What's the next step?
You find you.
You and you prime.
Where's you located?
You is located attached to the negative power.
You is attached to the power, whatever the power may be.
So you is x
fourth.
Fourth minus 8, and then you prime.
You prime is?
4x.
And what do we have where you prime is sitting?
We have a 5x cubed, so can't you just subtract 5? No.
And we have 5x cubed, we want 4x cubed. This is all multiplication. And I want you guys to empty your brains for a second.
Holy frick.
Try.
Okay.
Empty your brains for a second.
That takes a lot of meditation.
You got the x cubed you need, right? So that part's good. What do we want next to it?
Four.
Oh, okay. Empty your brain and look at where I'm pointing. What do you want next to the x cubed? So what are you going to multiply and divide by?
Four.
No!
Four.
Four!
Oh my god!
I totally said that!
Are you kidding? But I want to talk to you all through it. Logan, it's cool if you said it, but I want people to get there. So,
damn it.
Watch what I do, guys. This is important. What do I want? 4x cubed. So I circle everything that makes 4x cubed. What did I not circle? The 5 and the 4 on the denominator. So what goes out?
Yes.
Ooh, okay. Oh, that was cute.
Okay.
Okay.
I see you.
Changing the guess.
We all said that.
That's not. I'll let you stare at that for a second. Empty your brains, guys, when I say if you want a 4, you multiply and divide by 4. What if you want a 2/3? Multiply and divide by 2/3 and figure it out later. Don't think about it. What if you want a negative 5 and you have a positive 17? Multiply and divide by negative 5 and pull the 17 out. Don't overthink it. Don't try to make negative 5 into 17 or vice versa in your brain. You're going to go bonk. Exactly. Exactly. Your head's going to break. Don't do that. Don't go there. Make it easy on yourself. So what's my integral, people?
Yes.
5/4
times?
4x cubed. I mean, x to 4 minus 8.
X to the 4 minus 8 to the what?
Negative 2.
Over?
Negative 2.
Plus?
K.
So 5 times this, 4 times negative 2, and I get negative 5/8 out front. X to the 4th minus 8 to the negative 2 plus K, and I'm done. Jordan.
What?
I saw your hand up.
Oh, no, I'm just messing around.
Because, you know, this looks like a hand that was up and is now bored.
I was just stretching. I was just messing around.
Questions? This is the crucial bit. The have the want step and the making it look like the template step. Those are crucial. Don't overthink them. Okay? But you can't skip steps, because if you do, you won't get there. I promise you. I promise you. You ready for another? Yeah, Eli.
Where did that 8 come from?
Where did it come from? You tell me.
Oh, the 2 times. Yeah, okay.
And that negative ended up right out front.
Let's see.
Awesome. Let's do another. They're not so bad. It's extremely formulaic. Those of you that have been frustrated up until now with the fact that there hasn't been like a set of steps to take you through it, well, here's your present. Here's a set of steps to take you through it. Don't deviate from the steps or you will be sad. Very, very sad. You guys zoom tight.
Which one?
Here's a marginal revenue problem. 60,000 minus 40,000 over 10 plus x squared. Sorry, 10 plus x quantity squared. I want you to find total revenue. The first step is pretty intimidating, isn't it?
Yes.
All right, so not quite. You don't have an integral yet. Revenue is the integral 60,000 minus 40,000. And if you want to make it pretty at this point, sure, no one's going to stop you. This is integral number 1. This is a straight integral, guys. This is integral number 2. You're going to use 2 different methods to integrate this puppy. Okay? That step. I'm letting you guys stir it for a second. With where I've gotten to. All right. How many of you are kind of shaky? All right. Talk to me. Where did I lose you? Chantel? I think so. Amara? Aha. So I split these up. So you're cool with splitting them up, right? Do you see why I split them up? Okay, so this is going to fall under this process, and this sucker right here is going to fall under this process. Because what's really going on here, you've got an x to the 0 next to it. So when you integrate it, it's x to the 1 over 1, right? So this just becomes 60,000x. But this is integral number one. This is integral number two. A whole different set of processes. All right? So how do we get 40,000 to look like one?
40,000.
We could do that, but then we'd have a whole bunch of crap going on. What happens when we pull the 40,000 out? What's left over?
10.
Can I do that? Have I fundamentally changed anything? Nope. So do I have exactly what I want? Is this exactly u prime u to the n power? Great, what's my integral? Positive, and then I'm going to bring this sucker downtown and change the sign and get rid of that negative one. I realize it's wrong, people.
Bless you. Bless
it's Zoom time.
Thank you. Thank you.
Am I done? Here, God, I wish we were. But you know I'm going to say no.
Please don't. I'm running out of room on my paper.
Yeah, I'm out of room as well.
In order for the revenue function to be complete, you guys, I have to solve for k sub r. What's my nugget for k sub r? It's always the same. Go ahead, then.
Zero.
Yeah. Nugget for revenue, and this is always the case. It's set in stone. It's a cardinal rule. When you build zero things, how many dollars do you make? Zero. So when x is zero, revenue is zero. So we're going to put zero in for revenue and zero in for x, and we're going to see what happens to k sub r. Remember, up until now, k sub r was always what? But I warned you all that it wasn't always going to be like that. This is case in point. Here we go. So zero equals 60,000 times zero minus, or that becomes a plus 40,000, right? Over 0 plus 1 plus 0. 10 plus x? That should be a 10. I don't know where the 1 came from. Sorry, guys. Yeah, x plus 10, 10 plus x. And then that should be k sub r. Right here. My apologies, peeps. Yeah. All right. All I did was I plugged in 0 in for revenue and 0 in for x, and now I'm solving for k sub r.
In k sub r, it'd be negative 4,000.
Yeah, it's going to be. Who said that? Yeah, Carpleton. Fantastic. So 60,000 times 0 goes to 0. 40,000 divided by 10 is 4,000. Positive 4,000 plus what equals 0? Negative 4,000. K sub r equals negative 4,000 now. So your real revenue function at the very end of all of this is 60,000x plus 40,000 over 10 plus x, x plus 10, whatever you want to do, then minus 4,000. That is the complete final answer. Yeah, it took a little longer than the others, but it's the exact same steps. Yeah?
Why is it plus 40,000 and not minus?
Ah, because of this little step right here. Negative divided by negative gives you a positive. Questions? Comments? Fears? Hatred? Not so much the revenue. Okay. Just remember, remember, at its heart, it's the same problem. The only difference is now you're actually solving for the constant. Okay? All right, here's your handout.